That's fucked up, man. That child support's some faggot shit. That whole court system's some faggot shit.
That's a lot of fucking money.
All the court system do is just go up in everyone's pockets and take their money. I was reading, is that camera going? Look, I was reading an article today in the newspaper. There's some white dude, I think it's down in Texas.
Right.
He killed four people, he was drunk driving. And he got out on bail, walking around free.
Right.
And now they can't find him because he got a lot, his family's rich and he left the country.
Well, he gone. He's getting protected.
But just think of, say you's a so-called black person living in the ghetto. What happens if you drunk driving and kill four people? But no, what I'm saying, you ain't getting out of jail. You ain't posting no bail. Yeah, what kind of shit is that? We live in a place where if you're rich, you can just give the court or the jail a bunch of money and they'll let you out.
Right.
But if you're poor, you can't do that. But we're all equal, right?
Right.
That don't make no goddamn sense, man.
You see that faggot raised the prices of the pills?
I've seen.
They went after him for some type of business fraud shit, man.
Oh, yeah, I seen that.
You know, that's just proof that these
persons. The HIV pills?
Yeah. How he boosted the prices.
What is that shit called? I forget. That's a popular drug.
Yeah, hold on, let me read it.
You know, Charlie Sheen needs that shit. They actually playing that faggot ass music. I'm surprised he even got in trouble. It's probably because they need them drugs.
See that scandal with Gene Simmons is going on? It's picking up steam.
What, his daughter or something?
Child pornography. She's just speaking up for it.
So Gene Simmons.
She's just coming forward.
Because he's been a sex freak.
Yeah, it was on some child pornography shit.
Damn.
Yeah, they found out and it was coming through their Wi-Fi. Like somebody there was like,
it
damn.
Was Gene. I bet it was Gene.
Of course it was. They're trying to say he was out of town. That motherfucker, all you do is pay the media and say he was out of town. That's all.
But he's a Jew.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah,
so called.
Right.
He's an Edomite.
Yeah.
So Gene Simmons, time's up, buddy. They'll end up sweeping that under the rug. And he's a Jew.
I hope not. I hope not.
That's Esau for you.
Yeah.
Esau,
they
look out for each other. Especially him.
Hold on, let me get this straight. You're saying he's not an Israelite?
Gene Simmons? I don't know.
I think he is.
He has to be.
Because he's too cool.
All them fucking songs?
Cool. He's a cool motherfucker if you just...
Like God, he sings gay, foul.
He's my least favorite of the group.
There you go.
You know, my favorite was always Ace Frehley. You know, I grew up, you know, playing guitar. I like Ace Frehley.
Here you go. CEO criticized for drug price hike arrested. They arrested us. It's just further proof that these curses is lifting off of us and going back on
Esau.
Yep.
Slowly but surely.
Yep.
I want to see that curse to go off over the face of the earth.
Oh, man. Zephaniah.
Yeah, what we get it?
Yeah. That's some chariots. Let me read this. The former hedge fund manager vilified in nearly every corner of America for buying a pharmaceutical company and jacking up the prices of a life-saving drug more than 50-fold was arrested Thursday for running companies unrelated to Führer like a Ponzi scheme, authorized authorities said. And we was talking about this before.
Say a Ponzi scheme.
Yeah. they locked his ass up.
But
attorney,
this whole fucking country is rigged, man.
Everything, yeah.
Everything's goddamn rigged, man. Like we was saying, we was up in the hood. I went to go pick this brother up, right? He lives up in the hood, up on the south side, right? The south side is grimy. They call it the dirty south. We went to the gas station. Gas was what? $1.91, right? Then we went out to Grove City, which is, they ain't rich out there, but they got money. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's nicer. It's not the hood.
Yeah.
And gas money. Out there, it was like $1.60 something. It was like 30 cents cheaper.
They do got money because them motherfuckers
yeah,
driving around
money.
In a big ass truck with the
yeah.
doolies. With the
yeah, they
diesel
got big
trucks.
Doolies, yeah. the Rams.
They got money, man, because they got their land.
Yeah.
Excuse me, they got their land.
So I see it every day. The gas always costs more in the hood, and it's always cheaper in the nice neighborhoods every time. Same with the prices on food and the stores. Everything in the hood costs more. Because everything in this society is designed to keep your ass in slavery, to keep you down. They don't want you advancing up through the ranks.
Don't he look like one of them faggots that be down here?
He does.
He does, don't he? He does, don't he?
I bet the camera will pick it up. It's dark out. He look like a big Pee Wee Herman looking motherfucker.
Yeah, look like one of them faggots that be down here.
Yeah, talking some faggot shit.
Mm-hmm. Who the fuck's Professor Doom? You know who Professor Doom is?
Professor Doom. That sounds familiar.
Ain't that
Professor Doom?
Fantastic Four?
No, it was, fucking Dabu 7's live stream Friday. Professor Doom was on there. Everybody was praising
Dabu blocked
him? He blocked me.
He'll block people.
Oh, I kept correcting him. He kept trying to say the Most High's name is Yahshua.
He's on that Yahshua.
Off like a motherfucker, man.
I was like, that ain't ancient Hebrew. Well
though, so. That's all we know.
I think really Dabu's whole thing is he's got a nice little revenue stream coming in through his YouTube partnership.
Yeah. Oh, he's got all kinds of people watching his shit. There's like 1,000 people on his chat site.
I stop watching it. I watch his videos sometimes because he'll put out good information. But after a while, you get tired of hearing that Yahshua shit. And,
all he's doing is going to Alex Jones' channel and getting it from there and then posting.
Yeah, he's just reposting other people's articles.
That's all he's doing.
It's not his original fucking stories.
You know, he bugged out because he made a video that he parked the planet Nibiru was parked behind the sun.
Right. Same, he's on that bugged out Nibiru shit, aliens. He's probably one of the people that say the UFOs are demons and shit, you know? I think I heard him say that, talking about the Nephilim and Anunnaki and all this other shit.
I got no love for them.
He just got to keep his mouth moving, always be saying something. Don't even know what he's talking about.
Me and my brother, we used to drink and get, we had a good time watching Dabu 7 videos just to get a laugh. You know what I'm saying?
I kept saying eyes to the sky in the comment board, and so at the end of the video, he's like, this is Dabu 7. He was about to say it, but he just cut the camera off.
A couple years, y'all kept talking about this motherfucker, but I never knew who he was.
Yeah, we've been
never could find him.
I've been watching Dabu from the get, boy, in the day.
Yeah.
A long time Dabu viewer. Get back at the old house.
He was talking about going to the Serpent Mounds.
Yeah, we need it because Dabu lives in Cincinnati.
He was like, I need to get a metal detector and go out there and have some guys watch out for me while I excavate.
The member of KISS.
Excavate.
Rock KISS.
Oh, you don't know. KISS, that's before your day. KISS used to be like the biggest rock and roll band on the planet. I mean, the biggest. Yeah, they wore all the face paint and shit. Yeah, Gene Simmons, he dressed up like a demon, stuck his tongue out.
You probably saw his reality show he used to have. Have you seen that? Well, you don't know who he is, so you can see him. Gene Simmons got his own, I think he still got his own reality show, don't he?
I was watching one of those things, and he was called people Goyim, and said, I don't work, that's what Goyim are for. He said it on the show.
I know he a Jake man.
He's a white dude.
He a Jake man because he was cool on the show. He was cool with niggas, man. He was cool with a lot of blacks and, you know, just not even in the music industry, man. He was cool with a lot of them.
I don't know how you could survive in the music industry being a performer, being an Edomite, because the crowd will pick up on that. Even though they don't know the difference, they don't know what an Edomite is, but spiritually they can still detect it that they don't know, you know what I'm saying. Because you got to have charisma. Only Israel got that charisma to be successful on stage. Esau doesn't have no charisma. And Esau's a big faggot. Esau's the one who owns all the record labels.
No, the fucking Beastie Boys ain't no Edomites.
Yeah, because Esau's got pretty much Esau. He takes advantage of all these musicians, puts their ass out on the road, runs their asses in the dirt. Because they got these motherfuckers torn nonstop around the country.
Yeah.
They don't get no sleep, no rest.
Because they barely make any
and they don't make shit
on their sales, CD sales.
So they got to work harder.
They got to get
them. They got to tour more.
Your boy Scott Weiland died on tour.
They get pennies on the dollar.
I actually heard Scott Weiland, one of his last interviews, he was talking about it. He's like, man, I can't make no money more. I got to tour twice as hard as I used to. But that's really a good thing them record labels ain't making money like they used to. Like you said, that's part of them curses, getting back on them. You know? They used to take advantage of the musicians. Because all them record sales, you know, back in the 90s when all these musicians was making all that money, the musicians, they didn't hardly get none of that money. It went all to the record company. So, you know, the record companies losing all that money because of torrent sites and the Pirate Bay, good for them.
Jimmy LeVine.
Who?
Jimmy Levine.
Who's Jimmy Levine?
Dude runs Interscope.
Oh, it big faggot. Big
who? Who?
Jimmy Levine.
Oh, and I heard, what? Who was it, man? It was some big time musician said, I forget who said it. But he said he'd be up in the middle of the studio recording the album, and out of nowhere, rabbis would walk in, and they'd be going in there collecting tithes and shit from the fucking producers.
I can see that.
And he said the rabbis was running shit.
Mm.
Damn, I forget who said that, man. Mm. It was some heavy metal dude. He said it freaked him out when he seen it.
Probably Dave Mustaine.
No, it wasn't him. I can't remember. Go ahead, take your scripture out.
Proverbs 22 and 22. Rob not the poor because he is poor.
No, rob not the poor. Oh, that's what we just talking about. Like we said, everything in the hood costs more. Gas costs more in the hood. When you go to court, if you're rich, you don't go to jail, but the poor people go to jail. And they, all these poor people, they got to go to court every day, and the court system is taking all their money, robbing them, taking their shit. If you're poor, they'll pull you over if you don't have proper registration. Let's say that you didn't have tags on your car, but you was just about to get it tomorrow because, you know, you had to wait till you got paid to get it, right? Because you living week to week, paycheck to paycheck. Tell a cop. The cop don't give a fuck. He's impounding your car. They're going to take your car, take it to the impound, and you can't afford to get out, so now you don't have a car. And then these devils are going to take your car, and they're going to sell it and make a profit.
Damn right.
Tell me that's not robbery. Stealing. Now read that again.
Rob not the poor because he is poor. Either oppressed or afflicted in the gate. Let's get down to 28.
But when you really think about it, the cops really are the one of the number one afflictors of the poor. You know what I'm saying? Because they work for Esau. They work for the court system, and they work for the government. Mm-hmm. I know they're peons, and they probably don't really understand what they're doing. Some of them do. Because they're just mindless fucking zombies like everybody else. But they're going in there oppressing their own people, robbing their own people.
27.
Go ahead.
If thou has nothing to pay, why should he take away thy bread from under thee?
Yeah, that's what they do. They take their bread from you. Constantly, you get fined for this, you get fined for that. The car is the biggest deal, too. They know people need cars. So they charge you ridiculous money for gas. Then you got to get tags. And you got to renew your tags every year, once a year. It's not just say, oh, I can understand why you might have to have registration, right? So they know whose car is who in case you run someone over. But now it's a money game. They make you do it every year, once a year.
You be late on your fines. They're going to fine you more.
Yep. And then don't go to court. What happens if you don't go to court? They put a warrant on you. Now, when you hear the word warrant, you think like some Wild Wild West shit. This motherfucker on a warrant poster with a cigar like Mad Dog McGruff or something.
So much fine.
Yeah, you know, this dude's like a real murderer, killer. Like, he's like wanted, dead or alive. We got a warrant out on him. But they put warrants on people for traffic tickets. They, you know, like, because that's like a serious word, a warrant. They make, so they turn non-criminals into criminals. They pretty much look at us all like we're all criminals. They look at us, the elite look at us like we're rats and roaches.
That warrant costs too.
Yep.
That warrant costs. Filing the warrant, that's what they
warrant.
Do. For filing that warrant, it costs.
It costs. Oh, court costs. You got to pay court costs. It was $90 or something like that just for the court costs alone.
It went up.
So you won't tell me it cost them $90 for them to talk to you for 2 seconds. It cost them $90, right?
Oh, my God.
Where's the cost? Why does it cost so much? It's all fucking scam.
That's some scandalous shit.
That's some scandalous shit, man. This crooked ass shit, man. This crooked ass country. This country is a big pile of shit.
Here you go. Isaiah 10:1. Woe unto them that decree unrighteous decrees, and that write grievousness.
An unrighteous decree. Child support is an unrighteous decree. Here it is, an adulterous woman will commit adultery, have sex with 1,000 dudes. You might have got a bitch pregnant on accident. You just thought she was a whore you was beating up. You know what I mean? And this bitch is the biggest slut on the planet. She getting child support on you. You know what I'm saying? She getting rewarded for being a goddamn whore. Or a bitch could leave you. You could be married to a woman, and she gonna leave you, right? Commit adultery. And adultery is a sin unto death. That's punishable by death. She gets rewarded with child support. And if you don't pay child support, they come, they put a warrant out for your arrest. They come, they lock you up. They put hands on you. Throw your ass in jail. There's some faggot shit out here, man.
So they're hoping to put a camera in you like
this. Oh, no, they'll kill you. There was all kind of police shootings in the news this week. Did you see all them different shootings in the news this week?
Oh, yeah.
There's a lot of them. I mean, you think with all these stories coming out...
Here in Columbus.
You think the cops will slow down? They might be afraid to stop killing people? They killing even more people. They getting away with it, so they going to continue. And they'll kill your ass for a minor infraction. You get shot over a misdemeanor. I told you last week when I got pulled over, or whenever, what was that, 2 weeks ago? I can't remember. When the cops were a bunch of faggots. The dude was putting handcuffs on me. His hands were shaking the whole time like he was scared. You know what I'm saying? Maybe he was high. Because they, you know, the cops, they got a shoot first policy.
Ask questions
later. Yeah, they get, what they really do, you know? Oh, did you see that video?
That's almost funny, though.
That video of the cops shooting the dude on the ground? He was on the ground laying down.
Falling, yeah.
And they were just dumping into him. Dump, dump, dump. They just unloaded just multiple clips in this fool.
What do you think all them bullets are for?
Exactly. Why they got so many bullets? But they don't want us to have guns, huh?
Hell no. That's gonna spark a civil war when they drop the gun.
Oh. They're gonna come after the guns. That's good though.
It's gonna be war. You're gonna hear about bloodbaths everywhere. Ain't nobody gonna let their guns be just taken away, man. Motherfuckers have spent thousands, tens of thousands on their weapons and ammo.
They love them. They love them more than their children.
Yeah. They ain't gonna let that shit just go, man. Who in their right mind would do that anyway? Well, what two-thirds in their right mind? Because they got a different mind than us. They think different. Their rationality, logic is different than ours. So they ain't gonna let that money, that those arms just go.
Hell no.
They gonna go out with a flame, man. Shit.
But yeah, Jake loves his guns, boy.
I can't wait, though.
I know, I can't wait either.
I can't wait, though.
Because they're gonna have to have they're probably going to have the United Nations foreign troops coming to it.
That's what I see happening, too.
Is it? It'd be hard. Either that, they're going to have to get some real brainwashed fools in the police department to do it. You know?
Yeah. Because a lot of them and their families is the ones that's doing the suck on.
Well, I don't see why they wouldn't do it. They're already pulling their own people over, giving them tickets, right, taking them to jail, oppressing their own people.
Yeah, so they can bring in foreign troops.
Yeah, they probably
will. They don't have to. Because that's talk anyway.
Yeah, how the UN.
Yeah. And you know the UN is some vicious shit like NATO anyway. The UN, they carry troops. They carry arms. They go in nations and raping the women and children. There's all kind of reports on that shit.
Yeah, ain't no fucking around with them.
The UN.
The UN.
That's summoning
the
demons.
United Nations. That's the New World Order. Is the UN. That's why they formed the UN. Because they plan to form that global government. You know what I'm saying?
That's some wicked shit. The UN.
United Nations. Everyone's going to be united.
And them hand mites that work for them. They
love putting some hand mites in charge, don't they?
They got from every nation.
Yep.
You and you from every nation. That's down with that shit.
The UN, that sounds like the Tower of Babel.
United
Nations. And that sounds just like the Tower of Babel?
That's totally against the Bible.
That's Nimrod shit right there, man. That's Nimrod level type shit.
United Nations.
Bringing all people together. Because that's the goal. They want to have one government, one language, one religion. That's the goal.
That didn't, how did that work out?
But you see, they're working on, they're trying their hardest to make English the only language in the world. To fly a plane, you gotta speak English.
Yeah, that's the international language. Here you go, bro, Genesis 11 and 1. And the whole earth was of one language and of one speech. And it came to pass as they journeyed from the east that they found a plain in the land of Shinar, and they dwelt there. And they said one to another, go to.
Y'all know where Shinar is?
Shinar is
Samaria. Babylon.
There you go.
It was the original name of Babylon, the land of Samaria, Babylon, even parts of Assyria. That was originally in the Bible called Shinar.
And they dwelt there, and they said one to another, go to, let us make brick and burn them thoroughly. They had brick for stone, and slime had they for mortar. And they said, go to, let us build us a city and a tower whose top may reach unto heaven. And let us make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower which the children of men built. And the Lord said, behold, because the Lord was with that shit. Hell. And the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they have all one language, and this they begin to do, and now nothing will be restrained from them, which they have imagined to do. Go to, let us go down, and there confound their language. So the Lord wasn't with it. This, let's hold hands, everyone, and be one. E pluribus unum.
Oh, yeah, e pluribus unum. That tells you the United States was with that shit from the get.
Right, right.
Because pluribus unum means what? Out of many come one?
Right.
That's that one world order.
That's right. Go to, let us go down and there confound their language, that they may not be not understand one another's speech. So the Lord scattered them abroad thence upon the face of all the earth, and they left off to build the city. Therefore is the name of it called Babel.
Yeah, Babel. Oh, and like we always say, the word Babel or Babel, Babel, that's where you get the word Babylon. That means confusion. That's where the word Babel comes from. All that babbling.
Like a babbling bitch.
Yeah, a babbling bitch. It means confusion. Go ahead.
Therefore is the name of it called Babel, because the Lord did there confound the language of all the earth.
Yeah.
And from thence did the Lord scatter them abroad upon the face of all the earth.
Because the Lord ain't with all nations coming together and being as one. The Lord ain't with the United Nations. He ain't with that shit. The Lord ain't with the United States bringing all these nations in here. You know what I'm saying?
Not with it.
All bringing Muslims here and Chinese people and Japanese, mixing everybody together. Trying to make everybody follow the same culture, speak the same language. There's a reason why the Lord created all these languages and cultures. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I got a scripture to back. The Lord in the New Testament backs that statement up. Watch this. Matthew 25 and 31. This is what's going to happen when the Lord returns. It says, when the Son of Man shall come in his glory, and all the holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory. And before him he shall, excuse me, and before him shall be gathered all nations, and he shall separate them one from another, as a shepherd divided his sheep from the goats. You see what I'm saying? And he shall set the sheep on his right hand, but the goats on the left. Then shall the king say unto them on his right hand, come ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world.
You're talking to Israel.
Right, because like he said, he didn't say he was going to bring all nations together, did he? He said he's going to divide the nations.
That's right.
Because right now, because that proof the Bible is the truth. But what do you see right now is everyone's getting mixed together. They call America a melting pot. But the Lord ain't with the melting pot. That's why he's coming back, and he's gonna separate it.
That's what you're saying? Put the sheep on the right?
Yeah, the goats on the left. You know, Israel's the lost sheep, right? It's just like when you mining for it's like when you mining for metal. You mine gold or metal, You take the metal, you burn it, and all the impure shit falls out, then you left with the good stuff.
Burn that shit off, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's right. That's right.
Talking about a melting pot. It's a melting pot of diarrhea. It's a cauldron of diarrhea and syphilis.
Mess, old mess. Proverbs 11 and 21. So hand, joint, and hand.
Could you actually imagine someone sitting there with like a big ass cauldron? Just like all kind of shit and diarrhea, just pus and just, uh-huh. just diseases. And
thanks filth. For the visual.
And motherfuckers just sitting there with a thing just stirring it like. That's what America is, pretty much.
Melting pot. Fucking melting pot.
I'm sorry, I just had to get that analogy out there. I mean, I'm truly disgusted with this place. This shit is not an act. I'm not pretending. This is my true feelings on these subjects.
You can't pretend to be an aggressor.
Nah. I fucking hate. I wake up every day just praying that something happens to put an end to this shit. You know what I'm saying? Just praying the Lord come out the clouds, start destroying shit, missiles start flying.
Well, the money system, world money system, had another convulsion.
Yeah, it's bullshit. Fed raising interest rates. Look, man, I just wish this shit would collapse already. Like, come on with it. Collapse this motherfucker already.
They had a big shaking this week, man.
Well, they did too, though, right? So, hopefully, Lord willing.
Why on the financial network would they be discussing Israel going into Iran? Why would they be doing that?
Really?
They saying this projected 2016 actions that's going to take place. Israel going into Iran, oil prices going back up to normal. I mean, they going off on all kind of shit, but that's funny, though.
No, did they actually want the oil prices to be higher? What kind of fucking sense does that make?
Because
they make more money off of it. Because they make more, the higher the prices, the more money they make. Well, that's common sense too.
Common folks ain't arguing.
No.
They don't care.
They're fucking dumb, man.
As long as the prices go down, that's the only thing they're keeping their eye on. But they ain't arguing that the prices are gonna go back up.
Right. Well, I mean, you know, the average person, man, they're lost. There's nothing you can do for them. You can't help them. You can't reach them, you can't wake them up. It ain't happening.
They're foolishness.
Yeah, it's nothing but foolishness. They've been, the Lord made them retarded. There's nothing you can do about it.
Straight up foolishness.
Yeah. We
this
only
is
have
the perfect time and season to do it. Lower the gas prices, make it easy for people to make money, so kiss the season to be jolly can take place, you
to
know.
To keep them in that
child state of mind.
Yep, to keep them in the fucking la-la land.
Yep. It's all timing. It's all timing by the devil. This all time about it, you know. So 2016 gonna whoop their ass even more.
But like that old saying goes, the devil's greatest trick was convincing people he didn't exist.
Yep.
You know, that's an old saying. I probably said it wrong.
Nah, you got it right.
Yeah.
You got it right. Cause these motherfuckers don't believe in the devil.
They don't.
They don't believe. They don't believe. And they don't. As a matter of fact, they don't believe the Lord exists.
They don't.
Why is kept?
That's why I said there's no reaching them. You can't, because you see people, you see people like trying to teach the word and shit.
Look how docile
they are. They're gone. They're gone. They're like you said, docile.
Yeah.
Just like you look at the cattle getting ready to get put to death, they're getting hit with the bullet in the head. What do they use? The air gun or whatever to kill them?
Shit, I've seen this video. They took a cow, put it in this machine. They tip the cow upside down, and then they go over and slice the cow's throat. And then that's someone comes and hooks the cow, and then they hang the cow, and all the blood drips down into this drain.
And they just, all the other cows just wait in line, just
yep. Boop. And then once they get that one out the machine, another one goes right in.
Damn, it's fucked up.
And they think, to a cow, that's normal, though, you know? It's not, you know, it's normal.
See, you know what I'm saying? Goat screaming.
Yeah. A sheep, like, it's just peaceful. A goat is just...
Well, people will make fun of us. Well, you guys are actually called sheep in your own book. Well, that's a whole different analogy. It's a different take on the same metaphor. You know what I'm saying?
They don't get it.
Because we're called sheep because we're part of the flock. And like you said, a lamb is a peaceful animal.
That's right.
We don't want to hurt nobody. You know?
killed every day. Like, they're like sheep into sheep slaughter.
Yeah.
Yeah. But sheep is easily led. You just walk right into it. Fuck.
Go ahead, bring it up.
It's first Maccabees, 1:30-29. After 2 years fully expired, the king sent his chief collector and tribune unto the cities of Judah, came into Jerusalem with a great multitude.
Where you at?
First Maccabees.
Okay, so that's talking about the Macedonians going get collecting tribute. Go ahead.
It's back peaceable words unto them, but was all deceit. And when they had
exactly. The people you gotta watch out for is those people with a silver tongue. You know what I mean? Talking them smooth words. Just like a salesman. You know them salesmen that come? Yeah, you know, they're the nicest. They can talk a good game. And they get you to sign on that dotted line, and they're like, gotcha. You know what I'm saying? Gotcha. Yeah. Once you sign there, boy, that's your ass.
What's that episode of South Park when, what's the name? Butters went into that one restaurant.
I never watched it. I keep meaning to watch some South Park to stay up, but I don't ever watch it.
Raisins?
Yeah.
You know, raisins?
Butters, ain't he the retard?
That was the restaurant Raisins. Butters is just cool.
Butters
is just he got a peaceful spirit in all the rest.
Well,
who's
the, like, the retarded one? Like, he's in a wheelchair or something?
Oh, that's not Kenny.
Not Kenny. One he talks all funny.
Timmy.
That's Timmy. It. Okay, Timmy.
Jimmy Vollmer is, he's crippled retarded too.
Okay.
Jimmy and Timmy.
I need to watch that shit, because they always making good points, don't they?
You gotta watch this new season.
That's like a politically active cartoon.
Yeah, they stepped up their game too. They straight up stepped up their game too. All they're doing is cause conscience is becoming more aware, and all they're doing is just siphon out of it.
They're reflecting society.
That's all, yeah.
That's all.
It ain't hard to do.
Yeah.
I mean, like I said, if we were given an opportunity to make a movie or help one of them directors since they're skillful at it, can you imagine?
I already got the movie I want to. You already know what movie I'm making, the King David movie.
Yeah.
That's the first movie I'm making.
It'd be called King David and the Mighty Men.
That'd be the best movie ever.
That motherfucker would break all kind of records.
You were talking about blood. That'd be the bloodiest movie you'd ever seen. Half the movie be a battle.
And another one we'll come out with, The Chariots of the Lord.
We gonna see that movie. That'd be a documentary.
Yeah, that'd be bad.
We gonna be watching.
Oh, okay, we can do that too. A documentary
in the kingdom. We gonna watch that documentary.
Yeah, that'd be bad though, man. It'd be accurate. It'd be full of truth. You know?
Yeah, like we always say, they have yet to make an accurate Exodus movie.
Not nothing.
Some of them came kind of close, but so far away.
Yeah, but so, you know what I'm saying? But the funny thing is, the old shit was more accurate than the newer shit.
Was more believable too, I think. Like the old CCB DeMille movies.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Bible.
Yeah, oh, the Bible.
The Bible.
Oh shit.
You know.
That was a good shit.
Yeah.
The Ben-Hur's and the one of my favorite old movies is Quo Vadis. Quo Vadis has got what's this dude's name? Peter something. It's about Nero. How Nero was killing the Christians, feeding them to the lions. What's that? But y'all watching this, look up a movie, Quo Vadis. You'll love it.
Wow.
Watch it.
Okay.
It's got the the Peter and the disciples in it.
I'm about to check that out.
It's a good movie, man.
I gotta find it. I gotta go to the thrift store.
I got it on the Pirate Bay.
Oh, okay. It's
the only place I can find it. That's why the Pirate Bay is good. I don't get on the Pirate Bay just downloading new shit, you know? I be on there downloading old shit that's hard to find, you can't find nowhere else. Downloading software, you know, free software. Not like open source free software. So it's not just stealing. Because people say, oh, you're stealing. I ain't fucking stealing. You're fucking retarded.
Can somebody read that scripture again? Who was that? Read that scripture on how they say peaceful things. Just like how they say peaceful things.
Yeah.
To deceive the people, whatever, or something like that.
Peace and safety?
That might be some bad shit.
Yeah.
Back peaceable words into them, but it was all deceit.
Okay.
For when they had given him credence, he fell suddenly upon the city and smote it very short and destroyed much people of Israel.
Oppression. You know?
And when he had taken the spoils of the city, he set it on fire and pulled down the houses and walls thereon in every side.
And before that's all how this, they do you, man.
Verse 11, they explain how they took the customs of the heathens.
Hey, well, what do the politicians do? Who's the new Speaker of the House? Paul Ryan, right? Remember, they got rid of John Boehner because he wasn't keeping his promises and shit. And he kept, you know, joining the side, the more spending. He promised he'd stop spending, but he spent more. So they got this new guy, Paul Ryan, in there to be the new speaker. They had high hopes for him.
Yeah.
And then you seen the story on Drudge Report says Ryan gives it all away. The first chance he gets, he just totally stabs everybody right in the fucking back.
Right.
And that's every politician for you. Every last one of them.
See, that's a fool that keeps falling for that shit.
Yeah,
man.
Keep falling for it time and time again.
Cause another motherfucker come in. Oh, he gonna make change?
He ain't make change shit.
What the fuck Obama do when he came in? Shit. Motherfuckers. You see that stupid, remember the stupid bitch that said, now I ain't gonna have to pay my rent or some shit.
Yeah,
like that.
She said it.
I can't believe that shit.
Hey, maybe she didn't. Because these women really don't gotta pay rent.
Got a point there.
The woman could say that.
That's right.
Because they really not paying. They get food stamps. You know? When I go to Kroger, I see the woman's carts, the food carts.
Yeah.
The cart be overflowing. They dropping shit on the floor. It got so many groceries. But you look at men who are by themselves, they just got a couple of items. The men are always paying with cash.
And I kind of forgot about that too, man. Because that's kind of funny, because I forgot these bitches got Section 8 apartments. My sister had a Section 8 apartment. She was paying $15 a month.
Wow.
You know? It was a four-bath apartment.
Probably smoking weed, you popping know, pills all day.
My sister was a
cocaine. Why not your sister?
My sister was a cocaine.
Okay.
She was snorting cocaine, though.
I'm just saying the average woman, you think, oh, she's a good single mother. She's just trying to raise her family. Mm-hmm, no, these bitches are hoes.
Yeah.
They in these fucking Section 8 apartments having lavish parties, dicks getting sucked all over the place, just trains getting ran.
Oh, man.
Drugs everywhere.
It's not a stable household.
No, it's nothing. It's a party house.
Yeah.
Is what it is.
Yeah. No, I looked under the cabinet in the kitchen. I went over there and she left out. She's like, just clean up after you leave, you know, because I took a girl over her crib right down the street from here.
Yeah.
And I looked under the sink to get some, you know, clean the shit to clean the counter. And under the sink, wasn't no pots or pan, no cleaning shit for the counter, no nothing, but a mirror. With cocaine and a rolled up dollar.
Oh, hell no.
Under the sink. She didn't have the common decency to just get rid, you know.
Yeah.
That was my older sister, man. Living in that motherfucking apartment.
I seen in New York, they just had a big cocaine bust.
Oh, I saw that too.
They did. They got their own drugs back.
Mess up drugs.
Now they're going to resell them again. Mm-hmm. And then that, you know, people actually think the cops, oh, they're doing a good job. The government's the one who shipped them in. How do you think it gets here?
Right.
If they didn't want those things to get in this country, they could stop it.
That's right. Oh, wait a minute. They can see all the way to Pluto, though.
Oh, but they can see the Pluto.
Yeah, and it give you a whole bright-ass picture of Pluto, which the shit is fake.
Hold up, man.
Which the shit is fake.
You starting to make too much sense.
Yeah, you know.
You fucking stop thinking too much.
We fucking these people
out, man. They can see the Pluto.
But ain't that crazy, though?
Yeah.
They can show you a distant galaxy in detail, which the shit is fake.
Oh.
You know, the Pluto, isn't that the farthest shit out?
Yeah.
Well, how does it look like it got a goddamn beam of light on it?
You know all those pictures?
Let me pull up the picture.
Hey, you know all those pictures of the Earth they show you?
Yeah.
Those are paintings.
Put together?
No, they show the Earth, the continents are blue. Because I was watching this video on YouTube. This guy is actually a flat earther, but I don't really believe in all the flat earth shit. But this guy said he worked for NASA, and he's a painter. And he has a YouTube, I forget his name, man.
Dabuga.
No, he's like a really good painter. There's no doubt about that. And he said he's like a realistic painter. I mean, he said he likes fucking with people to paint a picture that's so realistic that you can't tell the difference between a photograph and a painting.
That's bad. That's bad.
And he was hired by NASA to paint pictures of the cosmos, to paint pictures of Earth. And they said all those pictures of Earth you see from outer space are all paintings. They're all painted by master painters.
He said that shit on Mars is from Canada. Picture of Mars.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Oh, yeah. What you call it?
I heard some of it was from the Atacama Desert in South America.
Paintbrushing? What's that called?
Airbrushing?
Airbrushing. There you go.
But, yeah.
It's just clever shit the devil does.
I mean, because it's all about control. They control your mind. You know, it's easier to control someone's mind than it is to control their body. You know what I'm saying? So they pretty much control everybody through their magical spells. You know, like a painting of the Earth from outer space looks so realistic. Well, first of all, they have a, you can get on YouTube, or NASA has a three-dimensional graphic of the Earth from outer space spinning, the Earth spinning, but the clouds never move. They always stay in the same spot.
Wow.
You can watch the Earth turn all the way around, and the clouds will be in the same spot.
Looking the same shape, all that.
It's just all fake, man.
That's funny, though.
Because the Earth is a fucking... The sun goes around the Earth. The Earth does not go around the sun. That's another lie.
Yeah, we're saying why would the sun moves.
Oh, I got one for you.
I mean, you watch it every day.
I watch
around.
It. Now, peep this. Now, if they say the sun is so fucking huge, they say the sun's like I'm just exaggerating, a billion times bigger than the Earth, right?
125 times bigger than the Earth.
They say the sun is so big, but the moon is so small. Then how come the moon and the sun appear to be the same size in the sky? What the average idiot would be like, oh, that's because the sun's farther away.
Right, right.
Okay, geniuses. Then how come the moon can perfectly eclipse the sun? And it will be a perfect fit right over the sun.
Yeah.
How is that? That's not a coincidence.
Yeah.
That shit was designed that way.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
You don't know how big the sun or the moon is. You don't even know what the fuck the sun is.
I don't know what the fuck it is.
It's a light.
But they'll tell you what's on it. They tell you the gases it produces.
Yep.
You know?
They tell you what's at the sun's core.
Oh, at its core. Right. Oh,
they've been to the sun.
And then been in the middle of it.
They've been right in the middle of it.
Lord, have mercy. Well, Jeremiah 40, what is it? Let me get it.
Because when you really start thinking about shit in a logical manner, man, you know, it's just so easy to figure this shit out, man.
What the scripture say? The discourse with a fool.
It's irksome. It's irksome.
Shit. Yeah, going to class, everybody just sitting there writing down notes.
They believe that shit, man.
What the fuck?
Oh, just like they've been teaching about Christopher Columbus discovering America when people were already here. Right? And it came out in the news. I think it was in Yahoo or something. It's been in all the papers. They just found, where was that? In Minnesota, I believe, or? I got to double check it. Just get on the news. They just recently found here. No, it was in Canada. In Canada, they found a Roman gladius sword.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You see that?
Yeah. They were saying the Romans was here in America.
Yeah.
Before the...
We've been saying that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, hold up. How did that get here? You know what I'm saying? So, it was never a secret that this... How can you hide this big-ass continent? Oh, they didn't know about this. How could you fucking miss it? It's fucking huge.
Before that, if they were.
That tells you how simple people are.
Right. Because the new world was the old world to us.
Right. It's all the same world, though. Uh-huh. It's all one world.
Yeah.
Shit, they called the Indians the savages from the start.
Right. Yeah, they said they were savages.
They already knew about them when they came over here.
That's right. King Solomon had his navy.
Oh, man, I got this book. It's in my car. I should have brought it out. Didn't know
what you got.
Talk.
What you got?
I got this book. It's called The Atlantis. Atlantis in the Amazon. Look it up. You can find it on Amazon. Get it? It's called. You can find it on Amazon. It's called Atlantis in the Amazon. But this book, it shows the finds of this last name is Crespi something. But anyway, they found shit tons of artifacts down in South America that you would have thought came from the Middle East. They found artifacts of Babylonian gods and artifacts of Assyrian gods and shit. They found all kinds of artifacts that you thought were from the Middle East, all found in South America. Look for that book, Atlantis in the Amazon.
Bad book.
It's a good book. Hey, I'll let you. I've already read it. I can give it to you when we go back to the car. It's pretty sweet.
Here you go. This is Jeremiah 31 and 35. Thus said the Lord, which giveth the sun for a light by day.
Light by day.
And the ordinance of the moon and of the stars for a light by night.
Notice he said the ordinance. Because the Lord, he put him in order. And it's like a gigantic machine. I don't know what the fuck it is.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's inconceivable. But the way the Lord put him in motion,
right,
and he
right.
set him on that course, and that course does not change.
Uh-huh.
That sun does not stop.
Mm-hmm.
It goes up and it comes down.
There's a scripture in Ecclesiastes and the Proverbs, in the Apocrypha, which the Lord said, don't search for things that's unsearchable.
You can't.
You know?
What?
Or unreachable. You know? And that's what Esau does. He lies and deceives people, you know, with his trickery.
The so-called science.
I mean, you can see the shit and you know the Lord created it.
Yep.
But we ain't gonna sit out here and explain that shit like we know our damn self. Our head will explode.
Exactly.
You know? We'll vaporize all that wisdom, man. That's why we can't have it.
Because we can't create a sun. Do you think the top scientists on the planet Earth, can they create a sun?
Hell, man, they can't imagine.
Since they know so much about the sun,
right,
they should be able to replicate it.
Right. This wisdom is bad, man. Why do you think the Lord said go out there in twos and threes or more, not just one?
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
You got to have a witness.
You got to have multiple brothers out here with wisdom, because we all coming from, we see the same shit. But we all coming out here in the same eye.
Everyone,
we coming different though.
Everyone got their own spiritual
gifts. You
know, gifts.
Right, man.
Just
this
like,
goddamn devil will have a professor up in these universities just totally making up lies and shit. The people eat it up.
They know what they teaching lies because they got their little secret, little fraternal orders.
Gatekeepers. Look at these fools. Children.
Even the so-called Jews, they brag about deceiving the Goyim.
Children.
They tell you to lie to the Goyim. Never tell them the truth.
I can't wait till this shit starts cracking, man.
Really?
You know what the hardest part about rollerblading is?
Fucking faggots.
What's that?
Telling your parents you're gay.
That's crazy.
That's a good joke.
Let me go back to this Jeremiah 31. Okay, ordinance of the moon and of the stars for light by night, which divideth the sea when the waves thereof roar, the Lord of hosts is his name.
Yeah, right, because the moon, the moon has multiple purposes too, you know?
So, okay, here's the point though. If those ordinances be departed from before me, said the Lord, then the seed of Israel also shall cease from being a nation before me forever. Thus said the Lord, if heaven above can be measured, and now what they say, that certain galaxies is
so many light years away.
66 billion light. They make up ridiculous numbers, man.
And then they say light. Yeah, the speed of light.
And the sun is so far. How they know, though?
It's impossible to know. It's just all, it's beyond conjecture. It's beyond speculation. Something I don't want to know about, huh?
It's crazy. Oh.
Oh, yeah. Whoa, shit. That's crazy. Loud ass shit.
This is crazy,
that shit
man.
Just gave me a headache.
But people eat that shit up.
Eat shit. Yeah, they eat shit.
Oh, well, we have no business talking about this because
we don't
have
a degree.
There you go.
We don't have
no. You have no verification that all that we know.
We wasn't certified by ESOL. We wasn't. Yeah.
You know.
That shit is crazy.
And that's only a fool that's in darkness that don't know a goddamn thing that will make a statement like that.
That.
Because that just shows that we have common sense. Which is common sense.
Common sense ain't common, right?
It ain't common. You know, because obviously it's not. Obviously it's not.
Yeah, because people will actually laugh at you if you say that the sun goes around the earth. They'll laugh at you. They don't believe their own eyes.
You expect people to have common sense, but they can't even read.
No, you're really right. Most people read at a third grade level.
It's their illiteracy dumb. Is really high as hell.
Motherfuckers can't spell for shit.
And it's mainly women. It's mainly
oh,
women.
Oh, yeah, they're awful.
Shit, a lot of the guys I work with, they can't read.
Yeah, guys
yeah, they can't. They can't
They
read.
All been in prison.
Yeah,
like,
yeah. But a guy has more sense than a woman, no matter how fucking stupid he is, though.
Yeah. Exactly. They know, like, certain words and shit.
And
like,
who's mostly fills in
dog.
The... All universities. You name it. Unless it's an all-male university, the majority of the students are women.
Mass.
That's backwards as hell. Back in the the learning centers in the ancient world, almost all the students were men.
Who's right.
Name all the greatest thinkers, philosophers from times of old.
Name one woman.
Hold up. I know it. Sorry, I can't remember. I can think of Plato, Aristotle. I can think of Pythagoras, Ptolemy, the astronomer.
Mother Mary.
Huh?
Mother Mary.
Isaac Newton.
Teresa.
Mother Teresa.
Yeah,
they're making
that's
her a
what
saint.
I meant.
They talking about making her a saint now.
But I can't think of one woman. Name me one. Nikola Tesla.
I'm trying to think, bro. I'm trying to think.
Come on, give me one.
Hillary Clinton.
Condoleezza Rice.
Oh yeah, Condoleezza.
Michelle Obama.
Oh man, she is so beautiful.
So beautiful.
Paris Hilton.
Yeah, Queen Elizabeth II.
Queen Elizabeth II.
These some foul ass bitches,
what
man.
What about Queen Elizabeth I?
Right. Oh, I got some shit on that bitch.
I already
man.
Know. She was a nasty whore.
Oh, you have no
And
idea.
She was a Jake, too.
Now, boy, you know what? The whole fucking family is foul.
Yeah.
The whole family. Everybody, man. But here you go. This is Isaiah 3:12. As for my people, children are their oppressors, and women rule over them.
Women rule over them. Right, yeah, this some backwards ass shit. Our forefathers, they would be just, well, we are our forefathers, but back in the ancient world, women didn't want running shit.
Shit, these women are more manly than the man.
Right, really, the women, the women are more bold than the men. Like, men are real feeble, they're afraid to speak
fucking
loud.
Fucking pussy-ass bitches.
Yeah, but, you know, the women, they're screaming at the top of their lungs, but the men, they talk like little girls and little faggots.
Yep.
Everything's backwards, everything's been flipped around. Up is down, hot's cold, you know what I'm saying?
Bad is good is bad.
Bad is good, literally, sharp. Right.
Yeah, yeah.
What the fuck are you about to do? Got the big ass demon.
And he's taking in his power to be the Most High, to be literally, you know, that's his thinking. We know he ain't.
Yeah, he rules through confusion.
Right. So his Esau being the Most High, this is it.
This is his
creation. This is his creation. He did create this.
And that's why the Lord calls this place Babylon, because it's the land of confusion.
This devil took to change times and ordinances.
Same time, literally, too.
Yeah, that's the scripture. That's the scripture.
He changed all the ordinances.
Yep.
I don't think there's a single. The only laws they uphold is what? But when they break them themselves, thou shalt not kill or murder.
Yeah.
I guess there's a punishment for that. I guess for some people there is. If you're poor, you get punished. If you're rich, they let you out of jail. So I don't know.
Murder, killing, and murder. Not the same.
It's not the same.
Yeah, we can't kill with righteous.
It's just take and pick. You, whatever.
Go ass up. Still, if you somebody came to your house, killed one of your children, and you killed them, they'd still lock your ass up.
You go through all the Ten Commandments. It's legal to break almost all the Ten Commandments. You can worship whatever god you want. You're allowed to commit adultery. There is no Sabbath. You're allowed to cover. You're encouraged to cover your neighbor's property.
No,
actually,
no Sabbath.
You got to keep up with the Joneses, right?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. covet your
own brothers. There's no punishment for adultery.
Covet your own brothers, man.
When you
they don't
see
want
that,
you to know your parents, let alone love them.
Exactly, yeah. Honor thy father and thy mother. Nope. Yeah. Like you said, you don't even know who your parents are now.
Yeah. And to be honest, yeah, that's true, because you really don't know.
You don't
unless
know.
Unless you look like him or something, but yep. You really don't.
Don't know.
So you can take on those characteristics just by being around them, though.
Yep.
Like my cat. He's got my spirit just from being around
me. Oh, that's true. Someone can take on your spirit just by being close to you.
That's true.
I seen someone
take
raise a kid, and I was like, damn, they look just like you. And they be like, that's not my biological kid.
So Israelite will have more influence on anybody.
You know, we'll have that, too. A lot of us will raise children up who's not even our own, but they're, you know, through the spirit of the Lord, you're there with them anyway, taking care of them. So fuck it.
Yeah. The Lord could have ordained them to be delivered.
Yep, exactly.
They, you know.
Put you there to watch over them.
Yep, that's right. We're not justifying a wicked act.
No, we're not justifying that at all.
That's what they'll turn it into, though.
Yeah, they'll turn it into.
We ain't justifying none of that shit. We're just saying the acts of the Lord. The Lord works in mysterious ways. In
very mysterious ways.
No. Because I ain't trying to raise them.
Hell no, I ain't trying to raise no.
That's some wicked shit.
That is wicked. But we got it, though. It happens all the time.
Yeah. And Lord, these motherfuckers be like, fuck your dad. He ain't here. Don't worry about him. Yep. I'm taking care of you. They actually do that.
And then they'll run their mouths. Your dad is a big piece of shit, that worthless motherfucker.
But they get all this child support money from him.
Watch Black Jesus. It's a character on Black Jesus. A woman be dogging her son. She be on every show. She's always like, his daddy was like that. His daddy was ignorant. His daddy was, you know, this and that. TV crazy, man. People buying that shit, eating that shit up, man. But they keep hitting it with it, going in one ear and right into their mind, man. They just can go right in the world and act this shit out, man. Looking down on their daddy. And the Most High take that shit personal when you look
out. Yeah, that's one of the Ten Commandments.
You know?
That's
you know?
One of the top. That's one of the laws that the Most High spoke himself.
I might as well read that, man.
The Ten Commandments?
Well,
that's when the Lord himself came down to Israel and spoke himself. Yeah. And then the Israelites was like, Moses, can we please talk to Moses? The Most High is too much for us to bear.
It's like we're nailing it in, man.
Yeah.
So I'm right. That's why I want to read it.
Well, the Most High, it was so important, he came down himself to tell everybody. You know what I'm saying? That's one of the few times when the Most High himself came out and told Israel what to do.
Here you go. This is Exodus 20. And the Most High, Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh, Shai, spake all these words, saying, I am the Lord thy power, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have no other gods before me.
Yeah, no other gods. In America, you can worship whatever god you want. They shipping 100,000 Muslims in as we speak.
As we speak. And you know what? These people are going to commit suicide. What I mean by that is, Obama said that I'm going to cut a federal funding to whatever state denies refugees.
Yep.
But in each state, got different cities. And each city do its own thing. So they gonna commit suicide.
Because each state is supposed to be sovereign. That's why a state is a nation. The word state is synonymous with nation. Each state is supposed to be its own country.
There you go.
That's why it's called the United States. Like, they call any other country in the world, they call them a nation state. You know? What Iran is a state. Israel is its own state.
Right.
What do they call it?
That's
the
right.
State of Israel.
That's right. That's right.
So each state is supposed to be its own, have its own laws.
That's right. And these federal funding that the devil talking about cutting, Obama, that is, this federal funding funds individual loans,
yep.
Small business loans, city loans for fixing roads. So on and so on. So these people gonna start killing themselves without them even knowing.
Yep. You know what I'm saying? It's all by design, too.
Yeah, exactly. So we're waiting for this day to come when all this shit will be shut the fuck down.
And Donald Trump ain't gonna make America great again.
Yeah, that's right.
We might not even make it to the 2016 elections.
Somebody might kill him.
Oh yeah, there's big talk about people calling for his assassination.
Hey, you hear about Rick Ross's album?
Assassination.
His album got pulled.
Yeah.
What?
Rick Ross's album got pulled from Walmart because he was rapping about it. I didn't hear it, though.
I didn't read about that. I sold it.
Mark Dice pointed it out to all the mainstream press
and
shit.
Why him, though? What he do? Rick Ross do.
He said he was rapping. He said Donald Trump needed to be assassinated. I didn't hear it though, so I don't know exactly.
It's just music.
I just glanced over the article.
It's just music.
You know, you used to. That tells you the so-called freedom of speech is gone.
I guess
that
Rick
used
Ross
to be a little bit of freedom because musicians used to get away with murder. Ice-T came out with fucking Cop Killer.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
If someone came out with a song called Cop Killer today, he'd be in jail. Bet.
N.W.A. fuck the police.
Bet. They would not fly today.
Yeah.
They would come after your ass. They would put a summons out for your ass.
Eminem had that one song, Mentally Ill from Amityville, accidentally kill your whole family.
Damn,
still.
Wait, what?
Who?
Eminem. That one.
Yeah, Eminem used to. Why, he still says sick shit.
Who what's the song? Hey Joe. No, Bob Marley. I Shot the Sheriff.
Oh yeah. That wouldn't fly.
Yeah, yeah.
Because musicians used to be the thing. Like, they could always use freedom of speech as an excuse.
Everybody and their mama would make that song.
Now there ain't no freedom of speech. Mm-hmm. It's gone.
Yeah, yeah.
The only reason we're doing this is because, you know, the Lord got some
ordained
kind of,
by the Most High.
You, before the devil get destroyed, the Lord wants to let this devil know he's going to get destroyed.
Nope.
And that's part of his punishment is getting verbally abused.
And it's amazing
before the physical
too,
abuse comes.
Because there's a
that's
big
bad though,
there's
man.
A big thing going on with all these universities shutting down free speech because people getting kicked out of schools for microaggressions. You heard about the microaggressions?
Damn, nope.
You know, everyone's a racist now. And any little thing you say, you can say you're a racist.
Yep.
So wait a minute. Microaggression
is like saying Black people eat watermelon, or Chinese people eat egg rolls. Or
see, I want to break it down.
Jews
where
are
get the micro from?
Small aggression. Like if you say something that makes sense, Chinese people eat cats.
Right.
Well, that's probably a major aggression.
Like they Chinese
people. Black
people
like chicken.
Yeah, anything like that. That's a microaggression.
Jews are greedy.
Jews have big noses.
Yeah, Mexicans work hard.
Mexicans, they say Mexicans
work
lazy.
Hard.
They say Mexicans actually are lazy. Yeah, that's what they say. Mexicans.
Hey, this Mexican I work with, he is fucking lazy.
They say Mexicans are lazy.
He works 80 hours a week, but he doesn't do shit.
Bugs Bunny and them and how they portray a Mexican. He's always walking around slow.
Hey, my brother.
That's all the Mexican is I work with. He's slow as fuck.
Really? My brother works.
He works 80 hours a week though. But.
Well, you know, Luke worked at Roosters. Him and
slow.
Him and Ricky.
What you mean physically?
He moves around slow and in my way all day.
Well, he probably smart. You know, I ain't gonna break my neck for this motherfucker.
They say at Roosters, that's
he just quit.
For real?
Video to do.
They say at Roosters, if you ain't a Mexican, you gonna have
you
a hard time getting a job.
You got any more than?
Oh yeah.
Because they said they outwork everybody.
Yeah, I needed one of these too.
our brother, he knows all kind of Spanish because everyone at work is goddamn Mexicans. He be teaching me all the cuss words. Shadow, what was we doing?
I'm going back to the Exodus.
Oh yeah.
I'm going back to that Jeremiah if y'all want.
Oh, that's right. We was in Exodus 20. It's always good to get back to Exodus 20 though. That's one of the most important pages in the whole Bible.
Okay, I read the first one. Thou shalt not have no other gods before me.
It
Thou
is.
Shalt not make unto thee any graven image.
Graven image? What's the Statue of Liberty? America's symbol. It's a symbol of the sun of Sol Invictus. Go ahead.
Go downtown Columbus.
Downtown Columbus, there's idols everywhere.
Yeah. Or if any likeness of anything that it is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth.
Anything that's in the water, don't even question that. We'll keep going. I know we're going to talk about that.
Oh, my goodness.
That's bugged out.
Right.
Make you think of that movie, The Abyss.
Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them, for I, the Lord thy power, am a jealous power, visiting the iniquities of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generation of them that hate me.
Yep.
And showing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments.
Yep.
Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy power in vain. For the Lord will not hold him guiltless to take his
name. It does. That's why we out here.
Oh, he's like, I like that. That sounds good.
We got that righteous vibration going out.
We singing that new song. Come on with it.
I got some over here. And showing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy power in vain, for the Lord will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain. Yeah. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
Oh, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. In America, there is no Sabbath. Every store is open 24/7.
Hey man, you know what the Sabbath is? You know what the Sabbath is? It's all right not to know, man. Put pride aside when you're discussing wisdom and knowledge and understanding. When you want understanding, put pride aside if you don't know. Just face it. Oh, it's I don't know because you're about to learn something. You hear what I'm saying? The Sabbath is a day that the Lord put aside for you to have rest. You hear what I'm saying?
And there ain't no rest out here.
When do America take a day off for rest?
Kroger is open every day. Walmart is open every day.
Gas stations.
No respect for the Lord's commandments.
UDFs.
they even call 7-Eleven. 7-Eleven open all day, every day.
Do they not got the police station going up and down the road all day long, every day?
Yep, the cops
24
don't
hours
stop.
A day, 7 days a week.
Hey, they call New York the city that never sleeps. No rest.
That's right. Ain't no Sabbath day, but the Lord said right here, and showing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments.
Nope.
You know, okay. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work.
And the punishment for not keeping the Sabbath, by the way, is death. So I guess America's sentence is death.
But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy power. In it thou shalt not do any work. What?
Any work, but this is nothing but work.
That's right.
People always tell you they don't do nothing but eat, sleep, shit, and work.
Eat, shit, and work.
Repeat.
Eat, sleep, shit, work, repeat. Just a never-ending fucking cycle of misery.
Stress. That's what the devil prescribed for you, is stress.
Even the woman, they make the woman work that much.
That's right. But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy power. In it thou shalt not do any work, thou nor thy son, not thy daughter, thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor the cattle, nor thy stranger that is within thy gates. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea and all that is them is, and rested the seventh day.
Hold on. That's why there's 7 days in a week.
That's a busy ass week.
The Bible's not the truth, but there's 7 days in a week.
Right. Wherefore the Lord blessed the seventh day and hallowed it. Honor thy father. That's what we was looking
Honor
for.
Honor thy father.
Honor thy father and thy mother.
They threw that one right out the window. There's not even no fathers to honor in this piece of shit country. Did they encourage the women to be adulterous and promiscuous? So there's no fathers.
That's right.
That's why all these women are getting Section 8 housing. To get Section 8 housing, a woman has to be single.
Head of household.
So adultery is sanctioned and approved by the government.
That's right.
And there's no punishment for adultery. The Bible says adultery is punishable by death.
That's right. And like you said, the government sanctions
They sanction it.
Your cities, your local city, state, and federal government. You know?
But if we bring, we're living in the dark ages. That's the old times.
We under the new law.
They say we living in the past. So what's the future? Syphilis, AIDS, gonorrhea? Children not knowing who their father is, and that's what you call advancing, right? You call anti...
Now that's evolution for your ass.
Yeah, antibiotic resistant gonorrhea. That's the new thing we're supposed to be interested in.
If we evolved from a rock to what we are now, where the fuck are we headed?
Yeah, from single celled organisms. We evolved from a rock. The rock mutated into a single cell organism.
But we haven't changed in what, 4,000 or 5,000 years?
No, no, even longer than that. Millions of years, they say.
Yeah, millions. Yeah.
Or 100,000.
Yeah, they actually said the other day, I think it was RT.
They found a new human skull. Oh, well, go ahead.
Oh, Lord, have mercy. They going off then. They saying that history of man actually predates. It's like 10,000 years older or 10 million years older.
Yeah.
Some shit like that.
Well, I seen this dude, Survive the Jive, just posted. That's my dude. He just posted some shit. They found an old-ass skull up in Europe that is exactly the same as the skulls today. And, you know, they dated it to 100,000, 200,000, 100,000.
Right.
Something crazy, but... there's no such thing as evolution. That's retarded.
I just thought of something. I don't know why I never thought of this before. The Most High said one day to him is 1,000 years. So when the 6 days he created the earth was that 6,000
years. 6,000 years. And that 7,000 years was the rest.
Yeah.
And everything was blossoming and growing in that 7,000 years, turned into a paradise.
Well, I mean, yeah, because, you know, the Lord speaks in parables anyway. He speaks in metaphors and allegories.
Like 1 day, 6 days, that's a busy-ass 6 days.
They don't know what that is.
Yeah, because that, why are you going to go into the whole thing? Keep going with the rest of the Exodus. Okay. That's a whole nother video.
Okay, I'm going to read that again.
It would take years to explain this.
Honor thy father and thy mother, that the days may be long upon the land which thy which the Lord thy power giveth thee. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not commit adultery.
Thou shalt not commit adultery.
That's why I wanted that.
That's why the Lord said this is an adulterous generation.
Mm-hmm.
A sinful and adulterous generation.
That's what he called them. He called them out on names, yeah.
And adultery is like the worst. That's one
that's
of the...
foul shit.
That's just as bad as murder.
Shit, if you don't want to commit adultery...
Go ahead, bro.
If you don't want to commit adultery out here, you got to lock yourself in a room for the rest of your life.
Yeah.
Looking at a bitch's or a dude's wife, that's adultery.
We're all adulterers. All of us. Yeah. If you've had sex, you're an adulterer.
Yeah. Shit, if you look at a dude's wife the wrong way, you're an adulterer.
You know what? That whore is not supposed to be out dressed or provocative with her camel toe in the first place with that dumbass nigga walking with her.
In
like
our
he
flesh
got a dying piece.
And our weak-ass flesh, we're sitting staring at it.
You know?
No.
Help but look at it. Because you see bitches walking with men that ain't their husbands anyway. All day long. You see it all day long, man. So the Lord is, that's why he's being compassionate on it.
Yeah, he's so.
You know?
Yeah, the Lord's compassionate. Like we said, a lot of these prostitutes out here, they done went far surpassed the sin of adultery. But the Lord, they can still have forgiveness.
Right.
But we is not excusing adultery nor prostitution. You got some faggot will come on and come, y'all motherfucker.
There's a righteous whore.
Well, I tell you what, I bet you more of them whores get delivered off the streets than the motherfuckers that's behind closed doors sucking on every goddamn thing, getting paid, committing adultery.
Because a lot of those bitches are ashamed of what they do.
You know?
They rape, they get forced to be prostitutes.
Yep, they do. The pimps would come up and they take advantage of them because they're young, they're poor. You know what I'm saying?
Addicted to heroin.
They get addicted. To get them on heroin. Because a woman's weak.
That nasty bitch that raising a daughter and a son, bringing in strange motherfuckers that fuck up the whole household, turn that daughter on to drugs and whore them.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
And then she's caught in that cycle.
Yep. Caught up in the cycle. And some of them will be delivered. Some of them will be delivered.
You don't know who the Lord's going to deliver.
You know?
Motherfuckers act like they got salvation on lock.
Oh, they've been saved. They saved them.
Yeah, they saved. It's up to them to
I'm
get
saved.
Right.
Like they have power over them. You know, that's everybody's talk. I'm saved.
Oh, dude.
I'm so blessed.
That's what
I'm
you so do. Blessed. I was watching some Steven Anderson this morning. I just seen, it was in my subscription. I was subscribed to him. He had the live stream. His 10th anniversary show was on. I watched about 5 minutes of it. But he's always saying that.
You didn't get struck by lightning.
You can take 5 minutes.
He's like, I saved, he'll say he saved people.
Yeah,
he's like, I helped save 3 people today.
Yeah. That's crazy, man.
You know that. That's that old Protestant shit. They be going up like, I'm saved. I was saved back in 1996. Like, goddamn, why are you still here?
That's that mischievous magic.
Oh, yeah. Here comes a demon.
That's some good shit.
And no gooder.
That's the fake Jesus. That's the fake Jesus of Jesus. You know Jesus.
Fake
no goddamn
Jesus.
Right?
This is this guy here.
Those some Jew motherfuckers. That's the devil.
That's some rats. Check it out, bro. Come Satan check it out, man. Seen. That's a drink for your ass. That's a drink for your ass later. Check it out, man.
Only Jake laughs like, only Jake does the dance and laughs.
Same motherfucker. Yeah.
You nailed it.
This is
you've been drinking, dude?
That's my dog right there. That's my dog right there.
He goes.
It's a check for you.
He's out of your fucking
mind,
man.
Anybody that dances and laughs, bro. All
right, listen. What do you guys talking about?
We talking about Israel.
We got it.
That's who we are. We're the nation of Israel. We out here to wake up the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Lost sheep?
That's you.
Lost sheep means they don't know they
Jew
Israelites.
You?
Not Jew.
With Jews, you lose.
Those Jews right there, that's the sin. They're not. Hey, get Revelation.
With Jews, you lose.
Yeah, with Jews, you lose.
That's got some smoke. Six, six, six.
Yeah, that's Mark of the Beast. Well, soon they're going to start putting microchips in everybody. That's the plan. That's the goal. Is to implant the entire human population with microchips. That's what
you
that
guys are crazy as fuck.
You're right. Yeah,
you're right, bro.
He's like, I gotta sit down.
He's like, I gotta sit down. You're crazy as fuck.
Smoke alcohol too.
Yeah, he fucking reek like a fucking brewery.
Just got hit with a big whiff of him. He fucked up.
Your boy did the dance. Yeah, bring that out anyway, just for edification.
You seen?
Yeah.
Revelation 2:9.
Revelation 2:9. Read aloud.
I know thy works in tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan.
So the Bible says, I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan.
Fake ass Jew motherfuckers.
You ain't got to break that down.
You sure don't. It's beautiful. It sounds beautiful just hearing it, man.
Exactly.
You know? It just puts everything in perspective.
It does.
You get your second wind back?
I had my second wind to start with.
Maybe you gotta get you another drink and come on back.
I didn't take a sip of it. I'm trying to figure out what you're fucking promoting, bro.
Well, the Bible. We're teaching the Bible.
Okay.
I told you we out here to wake up the lost sheep.
And not cross my hands or my feet.
If you get anything at all from this, with Jews, you lose.
Yeah, because those Jews over there, they're not the real Jews. Okay?
What Jews are you talking about?
The fake-ass Jews over in Israel.
They're the ones who control this whole country.
You got to take a look at it so you know, man.
The synagogue of Satan.
The so-called Jews who claim to be Jews today, they're not the real Jews. Okay?
Yeah, you guys together. I ain't gonna sit up here and read it while you hold it up.
That's too much. He can't read right now. It's too much.
We're prophets
on
the floor. We're prophets on the floor.
What about the Pope?
He's a Edomite too.
He's a so-called. Yeah. He's a crypto Jew. But he's the devil.
Where's he from?
Hell.
Edom.
He's from Hades.
Right, right.
So you guys are fucking off the chain, dudes.
No, but actually, you know, the Pope is a Jesuit. You know about the Jesuits?
Not really.
And what is the Pope wearing on his head? That little Jew hat.
Hey.
The kippah.
See the fucking Jew hat Obama wore on it?
Yeah. All the presidents got to wear it. Yeah. To get elected, they got to pay homage to the state of Israel. If they don't, because the state of Israel, because there's no elections, there's selections. So all the presidents, they all got to support Israel. That's why you watch the president. Presidential debate.
Where the hell are you mofos from?
You know, the state of Israel is the largest welfare state on this planet Earth.
And the United States give them like over $1 million a day, don't they?
Yeah.
They give billions of
dollars. Not just America. Germany is paying Israel reparations for something that never happened.
Yeah, the Holocaust.
Yeah, but you know what? In Germany, they did it.
The Holocaust never happened. I was there.
I was in Austria.
What? When?
85. I was in Austria.
That happened.
Dude, it happened. They killed him. They took him out. We're talking about 4.5 million
Jewish people. I thought they said it was 6 million.
Dude, I didn't do it, but they did it.
Hitler was a Jew.
He was a killer.
He didn't kill nobody.
He was a killer.
Obama's a killer.
Yeah?
Well, it's easy. Everybody hates, especially white people hate Obama. It's easy to hate Obama.
It's real easy. He's a target. Yeah. You get target practice on Obama.
Yeah, nobody likes Obama.
Did y'all see him on Ben Grill's show the other day? It was a special, because all they're trying to do is push that climate change shit.
Yeah.
So Obama went out in the wilderness with Ben Grill.
Climate change.
He went out in the wilderness with Ben Grill, where the ice sheets over the glaciers and shit. It was all a political show.
What kind of tribe are they going to start fracking some more in freaking Africa? I know.
Fracking's going on big time here in Ohio.
Yeah.
That's why we're getting so rich. Casey's blaming it on himself. Casey's like, yeah, I did it. He's a little fucking hunchback white boy.
Oh, yeah, Donald Trump called him out on it. He's like, the only reason you did good as a governor because you got lucky and struck oil.
He's got it right about it, too. Case against shit. Case is about busting the fucking union.
He's a big faggot.
He's a fucking homo.
He's a big fucking pile of shit.
All right, deuces, guys, I'm out. He's a deuce. He said deuces, I'm out.
He said deuces.
This dude is a piece of work.
That's an Israelite for you. If you did not, that dude's an Israelite.
Yeah, he's cool too.
Yeah, he's cool.
Just retarded as fuck. Yeah. Totally gone, man.
And I take, when people say we're crazy as fuck, that's really like a compliment. Because he said it in a good way. You know what I mean?
Yeah, he fucked up. He drunk as hell, man.
Drunk as hell. Dude over there dying.
Yeah, he on the cracking up.
I mean, you ever listen to Casey talk? He is a big faggot.
Man, I knew that guy was a piece of work when he walked up here. I was like, oh shit, here comes a damn demon.
How y'all feel about black people, period?
How you feel
come
about
on,
Bruce
here,
Lee?
Just for a minute, man. Just
you
for
think
a minute.
Bruce Lee is a
come
great
on
guy?
With me, man.
Shaolin monk. He looked like that dude, and one of them dudes on the background in Mortal Kombat. Hey, you know there's a goddamn, I showed y'all.
You know, it was a monk. It was an actual monk that went to Rome back in the day and helped integrate.